you're fascinated by the study of plants and animals, you'll love today's career, the biologist. Wendy?
Hey, Ryan, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks for coming out.
Thanks for having me.
Ready for a tour?
I am.
I'm Wendy Horan. I work as a biologist for Columbia Power Corporation. My job as a biologist in the hydro industry is to make sure that we're not having a significant impact on fish and wildlife or what we can do to mitigate those impacts. Being a biologist is pretty cool. It's a pretty diverse job. When I do get out in the field, I come out and walk around and see how things are going. Reclamation areas are coming back to the level that we are anticipating them. If I had my way, every day would be out in the field.
So what are we looking at here? Where are we?
We're out in one of our reclamation areas. So we planted this area up about 10 years ago. It's a work in progress. We have to continually come out here and take note and change how we're doing things. It's going to require a lot of time. Nature works really slowly. You may come out here one day and you may not see something. You may come out here the week after and things will have completely changed. Mm-hmm. We come in and document everything. Our little field books are gold. You have to take detailed notes. You have to be able to have a good eye for subtle changes that can tell you everything. As solid as your methodology might be and everything's been thought out, you're studying things that are constantly changing. Often you'll be out in the field and your research project is going, you think is going well, and something might happen. You know, the herd of elk that you're studying might do something that completely throws your study off, so you have to be able to think quickly and be able to come up with a contingency plan that isn't going to affect your entire project. I'll come out and do some stranding assessments for fish. I'll walk along the water to see after a flow change if there's any fish that have been impacted by that flow change and record it so that at least we have a record and then we learn from that research.
So how exactly does your job as a biologist fit in this ecosystem?
My role is to make sure that the operations of the facilities aren't going to have a significant impact on the local environment. I mean, everything's got a footprint attached to it. Most of our field work takes place in spring and fall and summer. But I'll come out here and take a temperature sample just to see how things are going, because
sure.
Fish are very temperature dependent. You definitely have to have that ability to handle sensitive pieces of equipment. If you're choosing to work more in the field, you have to be pretty physically fit, because often you're thrown out into pretty extreme environments.
As the human population continues to grow and developments continue to expand, industry continues to expand, demands on the planet expand, and as long as, you know, people overall and governments overall continue to care about the state of their natural environment, there's always going to be a job for biologists.
If you want to become a biologist, you got to complete your high school, you have to get your sciences and your sciences math. Once you're completed that, you go to university, you get your four-year degree in biology or something similar. You can get a degree in ecology, you can get a degree in environmental science. You don't have to go and get, you don't have to focus on a degree in biology specifically. There's always an enormous number of courses you can take and pretty much cater it to what your interest is. And then of course, once you complete your university degree, it's always good to continue to try and fill the gaps. It's an ongoing process throughout your career. It's not a 9-to-5 job for sure if you're getting into this. So your hours could be midnight to 6 a.m. depending on what the species is. If you're specializing in birds, you're gonna be out in the field early from about 4 o'clock on. Birds are most active in the morning. It can be all over the map. And it's a really versatile industry. You can go work almost anywhere. If you get a degree in biology, you can go work in a lab, you can become a microbiologist, you can go work in universities, you can work in colleges, you can specialize in any number of species. You have to like living things. And you have to have an innate sense of curiosity. And if that's your thing and you like working outside and you like a rewarding career and you like seeing results of your work, being a biologist is great.
Well, thank you very much for showing me around.
Hey, thank you very much. Nice to have you. Anytime. Yeah,
take care, okay?
All right.
Once again, I'm Brian for CareerTrek, reminding you that this career could be yours. See you next time.